Hi you guys, and welcome back to the Creme Kitchen. Today I am going to be making an amazing barbecued chicken quesadilla. First things first, the chicken. Super easy. If you don't want to do it this way, just go to your local Costco or grocery store and pick up a rotisserie chicken. But it's really easy. You get a whole chicken. I basted it with some melted butter. And then you just get your favorite rib rub seasoning and sprinkle that on top. I roasted the chicken at 375, and depending on the size, you're gonna roast it for about an hour or so, give or take about 10, 15 minutes. So let's see what our chicken's doing. Now that is an easy roasted chicken. Let's take its temperature, shall we? Now when you're taking the temperature of chicken, especially a whole chicken, you wanna make sure you insert this in between the breast and the thigh. You're gonna get your best reading. Don't let it go all the way down to the bone. So it's over 165, but who doesn't like a little bit of an overcooked chicken, right? Let's get it out. Just grab it and put it on your cutting board to rest. I'm gonna get a skillet ready and I'm gonna dice up some bacon and we're gonna fry it up. This is gonna be a great addition to your barbecue chicken quesadilla. Better to have more than not enough for this. We're gonna give this a rough chop and I've got my pan set over a medium to medium high heat. We're dicing it up, but we're not making it too small. Okay, let's get it in our pan. The sizzle of that bacon, music to my ears. While the bacon is cooking and our chicken is resting, I'm gonna prepare all the other ingredients for our quesadilla. Red onion, I mean, this is huge, but you only need about, well, it's kind of up to you how much you wanna put on each quesadilla, so I'm gonna just thinly slice about a half a cup. Next, we have our jalapeno. You know I'm gonna slice this up. I'm gonna keep the seeds and the veins in it because we really love the heat here. But if you don't like that, feel free to take all the veins and the seeds out. The bacon is ready to take off the skillet. I am now going to switch out our vegetables and let's dig into this chicken and see what that looks like. I just want you to notice how juicy this chicken is. Ava, close up. Took no time at all. House smells fantastic. Sure, you could go get a rotisserie chicken, but when you can buy this, do it yourself, why not? If you don't want to do this, like I said, you can buy the chicken, or what about leftover Thanksgiving turkey or Christmas turkey? A great way to use leftover poultry is in this recipe. So I'm just gonna start. Gotta save the leg. Now this is not a recipe where I'm teaching you how to cut the chicken up. Mm-mm, that's not happening. Let's get the thigh and the leg off. Let's get the skin, set it to the side, and get our chicken ready to cut up. Just a nice rough chop. You want all your pieces to be bite-sized, manageable. We're gonna get rid of all but about a tablespoon of our bacon drippings. We're going to add our red onion and our jalapeno pepper. All I wanna do is give my vegetables a really, really quick cook on a high heat. I don't want to get them real soft and mushy. I want to keep the texture and a bite to it. Back to our chicken. We have it in our bowl. I want you to get your most favorite barbecue sauce, okay? And I want you to drizzle it and toss it. Anywhere from a third of a cup to a third of a cup works. Exactly what I was looking for, okay? High heat, still have the integrity, the texture of the vegetables in there. They're not too mushy, but they've got just a nice soft brown to them. I'm gonna set this to the side. Separately, I have a skillet heating up over medium heat. We're gonna get our tortillas ready to go. We're gonna get the butter on there and then get our first tortilla down. Next, you're going to add your cheese. I'm using two types, Monterey Jack and a medium cheddar. Next, our bacon. Then our vegetables. And then our chicken. Then we're gonna put a little bit more of each cheese on top. I want you to put a little bit of rib rub or whatever seasoning you use, or you could go a little bit spicier, and I want you to put it on one side of your tortilla after you butter it. I don't know how I did that so well, but I did that so well. Once we flip, we're gonna get our garnishes ready to go. I've got some fresh cilantro washed up and some green onions washed up too. Let's take a peek. All right. Does this not look gorgeous? As I always say, we're not done yet. We have our quesadilla here, we have our garnish here. We need something to dip it in, and I'll show you exactly what. Do yourself a favor and get some good ranch. I had Lucas make some Hidden Valley ranch, which we're addicted to over here. You can't get it from the bottle. You have to get like the packet and make it with the mayo and the milk. Ugh, we're addicted. Okay, that is little thin. I'll talk to Lucas about that later. I don't want you going half and half here. I want you to go about 2/3 ranch and 1/3 your barbecue. Be prepared to be amazed. Now let's plate. And I'm gonna find out where Sophia is because I feel like she's really gonna like this. So good?
Yeah.
Could have it used more cilantro? Like a whole bushel?
Sure.
Yeah. Anyway, you guys, I hope you love this quick and easy meal. Thank you for joining me in my kitchen. Remember to like and subscribe to the channel. And I hope to see you again soon. Until next time.